Fantastic.
Hello boys, my name is Murdox and today I'm gonna make you an intro tutorial. I know I made one in the past, but it isn't that good as I'm like right now. I don't want to say I'm good, but I improved a lot, I think, and I want to show you guys how I make my intros now. So let's get started with the song we're gonna use. It's from Svantage, or I don't know how to pronounce that, Insomnia. It's a great song in my opinion. Yeah, so that's the song we're gonna use. So yeah, let's get right into it. We're gonna open Cinema 4D. First of all, I'm gonna make some render settings. So you go over there, click on it. Then you see output. I like to do 720. And I'm gonna scale it up later to 1080. So 1280 by 720. And that's the trick I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make the resolution 100 pixels, so you don't see a difference when I scale it up to 1080. So we're going over here, and you're gonna change current frame to all frames. Then you go to save and select all these. And if you don't see that, you just see this and press on that arrow, and you're done. I'm gonna deselect sound and select off edges. We're also gonna change PSD layers to PNG. Then we go to anti-aliasing, make geometry best and make the max level to 2x2. Then you go to options and make the ray depth 7, just like the shadow depth and the reflection depth. We're gonna make that 3. Then what I like to add, that's all what you can choose. I'm gonna add a soft filter and make it 9%. I'm gonna add global illumination and set that to low and set that to low. And I like to add ambient occlusion, make that 1 and that 16. So these are my render settings. So let's get on to the text. So you go here to MoGraph. Click on it and select mode text. We're gonna make a copy by Ctrl C, Ctrl V. Select both by holding Ctrl. Go to object, change the text to your name or yeah, whatever you want. I like to do Murdox because that's my name. Then you go to align and make that middle. And now you're gonna select the first one, make the depth 60. Select the second one and make the depth 40. Then you're gonna select both again and go to caps, make them fillet cap 11, 11, and 2, 2. Then you select the second one and make that 3. So now you have done this, you see, like it has a really small edge. So you're gonna select the second one, go to your moving tool, click on the arrow, press shift, and go back with one slide, and you see it's perfectly centered. So now we have text, we also want to have a font. So you select both again, go to object, and you're gonna select the font you like. Let's see a font. I think this one is good. Cybertooth. You can download free fonts on the font.com. So now I have this. I'm gonna select both again, press C, control click over here on the scores, I don't know. Then you're gonna minimize those and you're gonna drag them in the other letters, so you have one per letter. And when that's done, we're gonna select them all and you can delete those mode text groups. Now if I'm gonna rotate, you see it isn't in the middle. So what we're gonna do is you go over here to mesh, axis center, check those two, include children and all objects, select your letter and press execute, and do that for all the other letters so we can rotate them from the middle. So now that's done, you're gonna select, you go to chord and make it all 0. Okay, except for the first one. So that's, you can select them all and make it all zero, except for the first one. Okay, now we have the text. We're gonna get a kind of group. It's called a fracture. So go over here to MoGraph, fracture, and you're gonna select all your letters and put them in that fracture. Now we're gonna get a camera by clicking just on the camera icon. It will look different for you maybe, but that's because I use R17. Later on I will explain in the materials how to do it for R14, so no worry. Click on a black box over here to get into your camera. And now change everything to zero. And now we can zoom in and zoom out perfectly. And what I like to do is make the focal length in object to 24. I don't know why, but it gives more depth to it, I guess. So yeah. And now we're also gonna get a circle for the camera. So click on this and hold it and get a circle. Drag your camera on the circle and you have your cam movement shit. So now we're gonna make materials. This is a kind of weird part for me because I also have to explain in R14. And yeah, it's gonna be a little bit tricky. So yeah. You double click in this weird box over here or create new material. You're gonna open up by double click. I'm gonna give the name Iron. So. First of all, you go to internet. I'm gonna search for let's say iron texture seamless. Now you see you have like a lot of results, and we're gonna just get the first one, I guess. Yeah, well, you can scroll down and see what you like, but I think, well, maybe. Let me look. Now we're gonna take the first one. You're gonna save it like iron texture. So now we're gonna make the iron, and you click on this arrow, load image, and now you go to your folder where you saved it. That's for me in here, iron texture, and press no. We're gonna make the color black, and we're gonna do this. Copy channel, go to the fusion and paste channel. Just keep it like this. And then we go to reflectance. In R14 it won't, it isn't like, the name isn't reflectance, it is reflection. So you have to select it. And in R17 you have to do add reflection, and then it's like almost the same. So yeah, you're gonna paste it also over here and make the mix strength 75. And the brightness 65. You're also gonna make the color like dark grayish. And that's the same for the normal reflection in R14. As you can see, I also don't have a normal specular in this row. So R14, just go to specular and then you see this. Well, what I like to do is make the color also dark gray and make this metal, so it gives, it gets like a darker spot. And then we go to bump, select it, paste channel again, and make it around 6. And we're gonna take a look if that looks good. I don't know. Then you select them all, seamless, and change this to cubic, And let's see. Oh shit, I forgot the lights. Damn, how newbie am I? We're gonna create a new material. And we call it HDRI. We're gonna deselect reflectance and gonna select luminance. Get a gradient, click on a gradient, make it 2dV. And click over there, there, and there. Now make that black, white, white, black, and white. So now you and make the turbulence around 7 or something, not too high. Copy channel, go to luminance, base channel, and make it 65 the mix strength. So now we have like a light room, but we also need like an object to put it on. So you go here to floor, sky, right click on sky, compositing, seen by camera, uncheck that. Then you can drag on your HDRI, and yeah, we make it. We're gonna give it a group with the name light. So if I'm gonna render it, it will look pretty disgusting. Okay, so yeah, you just change that to whatever you want, and yeah, see you guys when it's all done. Okay, let's see to this well. Okay, yeah, it's okay. Okay, guys, I'm back. I changed a few things, like the reflectance. I made it on 60, and the color 60. And that's pretty much all I did. And now, if I render it out, it still looks disgusting. But when I add like random and give it some rotation points, it pretty look, yeah, it does look clean. So yeah, that's, yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. So that's our metal we're gonna make. So let's keep this random just for the materials, and we're gonna make a new material, and we call it color. And I'm gonna do blue because that's easy to make for me. I don't know why. And do it like this for the color. Then check diffusion and check bump. Now we're gonna search almost the same, but then metal. I don't know why, but oh shit. Okay. Then you're gonna search for a nice pattern thing. Yeah, something like that, like MiGuArch used, or yeah, I don't know, you can choose almost whatever you like, but I'm gonna go straightforward for this one because it's really easy to use. And don't use things like that because it has a border around it and it isn't easy to edit. Maybe I'm gonna use this because it's easy. Okay, so you're gonna save it like metal or color texture. Save it, and then you go back and you're gonna go load image, get that one, press no, make the mix strength 52, channel. base channel, go to your reflectance, add reflection legacy or just normal reflection for the you guys, go to the specular and make it metal. You guys see plastic, I forgot to say that, but make it metal. So change the color, then go to your reflection, change the color to a little darker blue, like that. Then you're gonna do this and base channel, and now it's like gray, so we're gonna make this 62 and 82. So we're gonna open this up and we see we have letters without any material, so we're gonna drag it on them because that's the middle part. Now I'm gonna select them all by holding Ctrl and clicking on them and check seamless and make them cubic. Now if we're gonna have a quick render, I'm gonna give it some more rotation. We're gonna see we have some pretty nice materials and it was really easy to make. And I see you have like a lot of reflection, so you can change the reflection to even lower, like that or something. Now it won't look that disgusting, I guess. You still see like big reflection, so it doesn't even matter. Let's check. Yeah, I'm fine with this. Okay, so now we have some pretty good materials, and now we can delete the random. I'm gonna save it just for, yeah, so it won't be gone when it crash. I don't know, tutorial. Okay, now we're gonna do the song, and what I like to do is in a, yeah, I like to do it in a different way, but go here to the cube and get a null object, make just a random keyframe, right click on the null and show tracks. This fenster will pop up and you click on the null, right click, add special tracks, sound. Now you can delete the rotation, scale and position, click on the sound and you see these three dots, click on it, get your song, and if you close it, you will hear the song. Okay. Oh yeah, by the way, I forgot. Press Ctrl D for and copy these settings because it gives a better look to the materials. I know it's a bit messy, but sometimes I forget things to say. And by the way, if the sound glitches a little, hold this and deselect all frames. So, yeah, it won't lag anymore. Okay, but now we're gonna place some keyframes. So you go over here, animation. Gonna throw that down so we can see it. And then we're gonna listen carefully to where we wanna place it, the keyframes. Now we're gonna click this to set a keyframe, and as you guys can see, I made a shortcut for it, so it's a little bit faster. And I'm gonna double click that, so we have a keyframe. Now we have like markers, so we know where we can put the C4D sync, and yeah. That's where I put it. Drop. And yeah. Oh, now we're gonna go back. I'm gonna save it. So what I start with is doing the text rotations. I don't know why, but okay. This is this drop, and I'm gonna start like that. Then go 5 back for part in the fade in. Then we go let's do like that, and a little bit like like that. Okay, maybe not. Maybe like that, and then we're gonna do things like this. Then it looks like this. I see I messed up some keyframes. Okay, now it's all fine. Oh. So that's our fade in. Now you go to like the other parts and go 3 back. Then you're gonna make it like this, so it's pointing forward. I'm gonna change this, by the way. Then you go 3 further, and then you're gonna do it like that. Then you go to your next keyframe. Damn, I don't know where those frames are. Yeah, here. 1, 2, 3. Gonna rotate it a little bit further, and 1, 2, 3, and like that. Then you go to your next one, and then 3 back, and a little bit forward, and 1, 2, 3 back. It's just do some random rotations, and yeah, it's all on your opinion, what you like. And I like this, I guess. I don't know. It's pretty decent. Now we go to our last frame, and yeah, point it like forward. And let's see how it looks. Probably disgusting. Okay, I'm gonna do this a little bit backwards, so this more like that, yeah. But it doesn't look good in my opinion. Like this part is really weird. So we're gonna click on the fracture, select this one. So I've got that one, and right click on it, animation, show F curve. And as you guys can see, it looks pretty okay from the beginning. But I'm gonna give it some little tweaks so it looks better. And we want to keep it smooth. So, as you guys can see here, it's all, well, it's pretty smooth. And but over here you see like there's almost a straight line, and we don't want that. So we're gonna drag this down a little bit. This one a little bit up. And do things like that. So, yeah, kind of like that. that one is good. We're gonna drag this one down. We don't want a straight line. So yeah, that's all, I guess. And then we can also check that one. That one is pretty okay. And now if we're gonna check it, it looks pretty good. As you guys can see, now it's smooth, and that's what we want. So we're gonna add some effects on it. I think we're gonna do a random over here, or a random here. Now we're gonna do a random on the drop. So go to MoGraph, effect random, and deselect position, select rotation, and just do things like that, pretty decent. And then go to effector, control, press the dot to keyframe it, go 3 frames back and make it 0, and control keyframe it again. Now it looks like that. Maybe it's a little bit too heavy, so I'm gonna make it like 51. Then we go to our next keyframe, we make it like 100, so it's smooth. But if 100 looks good for you, like on the drop, make it like 120 or something. Make it a little bit higher, the percent, so it's, yeah, it's a little bit smoother. So now we go 3 frames forward and get it back to 0. Yeah, that looks okay. So that's one effect. Now we're gonna select our fracture again, go to MoGraph, effector, step, go to parameter, deselect scale, add rotation. I would like, yeah, say something like that. And then 0. I don't know if that looks good. Nope. So you're gonna make it, instead of negative, you're gonna make it positive, so it looks better. And again, make it like a little bit smoother. So I'd say 150. And here, back again with, yeah, a little bit, and go. Yeah, let's say like that. So it looks like this. Okay, that looks terrible. Okay, don't do that. Just make it 0 here. Okay. Okay, we're gonna just place it over here so it looks better. Only now we have to make this negative 115. And now we can get this to 100 again and go to here and make it 0. Like that. Looks pretty dope in my opinion. Let's decrease that to 100. Yeah, I like that. Okay, and yeah, okay. We're gonna do here something with the letters. So we select them all, keyframe, 3 forwards, and we're gonna do things like that. And we just drag them against, I don't know, it says away from each other, so we have like a little spacing between it. Then we go to our next, and that's that one. Nope, that one. And we're gonna drag it all a little bit further, so it has a smooth transition. Like that. And then go 3 further, select all, click on that keyframe, Ctrl C, V, and now it looks okay. And now I'm gonna add a last effect. It's one of my most favorite ones, and it's called the formula, I don't know. And I'm gonna deselect the scale and make the first one 0, make that one 4, -2, +2, -2. Now as you can see, it wiggles. And I fucking like that. So we're going to here, Control keyframe, 3 back, and 0. So now it looks like that. Maybe I'm gonna turn that one off. Now we only have it jumping. Don't need that one. No. Okay, let's do that one off either and make it like 2. Yeah, like that. Yeah, I like that. So it's bouncing around and it's, yeah, pretty cool in my opinion. Okay, and for the start, we are also gonna do something with the letters. So you go over here and 100. So now it's everything is like normal. And here it is. Yeah, we go to chord and make these around 9. So they are all a little bit smaller. Or let's do 8. So let's keyframe that and do things like that. Oh no, we're gonna do that after that. And here we're gonna have them like 0.3. And now we're gonna give them all a weird rotation. Let's do give them just a random rotation. Doesn't matter how it looks, the rotation, but as long as it is a rotation. And last one. So now it looks like this. Okay, now we have done this, we're gonna make a spline, because why not? I'm gonna start with a, let's say, a oil tank. I'm gonna rotate it, make it a little bit longer. Longer. Jeez, English is fucking hard. And also, can it be bigger? Yeah, radius. Okay, like that maybe. And gonna decrease. Oh, no. One. Gonna decrease that. Like that. Then we're gonna get an anthem ray. And we're gonna find it here and drag it in there. And then you have that. Make the cylinder radius one and the sphere radius one. Give it a color. Now we go to like the drop, that was 75. So we're gonna all the size make it 0. Then we go 5 back. I'm gonna make it 1. I'm gonna drag it into the fracture so it rotates. Let's do it on all 0 right now. Yeah. Yeah, that looks pretty good in my opinion. Okay, and I like to do a real spline over here. So I'm gonna get some circles and make it 250 the radius, and then let's get one and let's copy that, make the second one 3 or 4, get an sweep NURBS by clicking on that one and select the sweep. We're gonna first drag the big circle in it and then the small one. Now we have this, we're gonna give it let's say we're gonna give it an iron color. I think that will look good. Let's see. Yeah, that looks pretty good, I guess. Yeah. Okay, by the way, we can scale up. Oh, damn. Shit. Okay, and now we've done this, we can give it a an animation. So let's do like this, control click on it, go to 20 frames, 30 frames further, make that 100, go 10 frames back, control click on that one, and go to there and make that 102. Then I like do that's like that. Okay, now we're gonna get a cloner by clicking on MoGraph and then cloner, drag it in there, click on a cloner, make it radial. Now if you can see, we already have a weird kind of spline, but let's do 4 and do something with that. So something like that. But then we're gonna drag that behind the text, like that, yeah. So it looks pretty dope. And it also goes through the letters, like, nice. So, okay, that's that. Now we also have a spline. It's really easy to make splines, though. Maybe we can do another spline here. Click on there, get a helix. Place it around there. Little rotation. Now go to, make it around the height about 2500. I don't know. Just mess around with those settings. And then rotate it a little bit. I guess we can do one like that. Then we click on there again, we get a rectangle. Make it like 20 and 10. Then we get another sweep knurps and drag the helix on it and then the rectangle. Oops, yeah, like that. Now we can see we click rounding, make that one, and then we go around like, I don't know, that, make it 0, go to there, make it 100, go a couple frames back, keyframe that one, go to there and make it 0. Now we're gonna apply that one for there. Oh, it looks okay. So now we're gonna do some animations. You're gonna start with drop. At least that's what I'm doing. So we're gonna get the rotation tools. Sorry, but I'm using all the shortcuts. We're gonna start like that. Go 5 frames back, do something like that, a little bit over there. And if you're gonna watch this, oh shit. Shit, it looks weird. So I'm gonna redo that. 5 frames back. And then like that. Yeah, okay, I can live with that. Then we go to our next thing and we're gonna do it like that. 3 frames further, full rotate almost 180 degrees, I guess. Then we go like that. 3 further. Oh shit. That's not what I was meant to do. Then we go to our next one. We'll go a little bit further. 3. And now what we're gonna do is give it a rotate to that side. And give it a little bit of rotation. Go to the next frame. Oh, and we're going more like that. More rotation. 3 further. Rotation or something, I don't know. Okay, like that, yes, something like this. Then we'll go to our next keyframe. Now we're gonna bring it around this. and we do like that. And then we go like that. Like give it just a little rotations. And yeah, something like this. Then we can go to our last one. And then we give it a little bit more rotate like that. And if we're gonna watch it, you see it's just a lot of rotations and do some weird stuff. As long as it don't look weird or it goes too fast. Yeah, that's pretty okay. So just save it, and then we're gonna do the F curves. Just make it all a little smoother. That one is pretty smooth. You can click here to see like how it looks normal. So without any weird side on it. So we're just gonna make a lot of smooth. And this is, yeah, okay. You just want to have those lines going up and down. And just edit them. Yeah, I don't know how to explain it like really good. But as you can see, it's mostly just smooth. Like it goes, it's not in weird shapes, it's not too edgy, it's all with curved, yeah, except for this, but yeah. Yeah, I don't know how to explain it, it's really hard, and I'm tired. So, yeah, if you have something that looks smooth enough, and don't have weird shit, then you can, yeah, exit it. And as you guys can see, it was here a little too fast. So we're gonna make the keyframes between it a little longer so it looks better. But overall it looks pretty nice, the movements. But now we're gonna do the camera zoom in and zoom out, that shit. So we're gonna select both and we go to the drop and we do like that. We go with that you go like the keyframe back, the previous keyframe. So now we do like that and we're gonna zoom out over here so it looks like this. And we're gonna zoom out, go back, zoom in. Next, zoom in. So also it's also for the camera, it has to be smooth. Like it doesn't, if it's, because it zooms out over here, it also means you have to zoom out a little bit more, like you can see, and not zoom in because that will look fucking stupid. So the number one rule is it has to look smooth. Otherwise, I don't know. People don't like it mostly then. But okay, we zoom in, zoom out. Zoom out a little bit more. Zoom in again. And then zoom out. It's a lot of zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out. But yeah, I don't know. Yeah, here we can zoom out a little bit more. Maybe a little too much, but that doesn't matter. Here we're gonna zoom in again. Okay. that looks pretty good in my opinion. So now I'm gonna see how it looks with colors. Now does it look from this angle? By the way, the CC will make everything like a lot better, so don't worry if it looks shit. But yeah, this looks pretty good. Let's see that angle. Yeah, I like that angle. Okay, so yeah, this is kind of... Yeah, I think this is the most important of all Cinema 4D. So I think we're done with the Cinema 4D. So I'm gonna save it. And call it intro tutorial. And now we're gonna render it. So guys, when it's rendered, I will see you back in another part of the After Effects. So, and we're back. After the render is done, we're gonna do the After Effects part. So you have to open After Effects, double click in this box, and if you don't see it, go to here and click on standard. Then you double click in it to import things, or you can right click on it. And we're first gonna get our song, and that's in here. And then we're going to our file to our render, let's say that here. So now we're gonna double click on a composition so it open automatically, and we're gonna drag the song in. So okay, first what I'm gonna do is make a copy of the PNGs, and we're gonna get shine. That's a free, I don't know, but I got it for free. So, and I'm dragging it up the on the second PNG layer, make the ray length 3, go to colorize 3 color gradient to 1 color, and let's say a nice light blue like that. So now we have a shine. First, let's give it a pre-render so we see how it looks with song, etc. As you guys can see here, the T is a little fucked up, but it's okay, I guess. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fade in. So we're gonna open this whole layer and drag it to negative 48, then go to 2 seconds or just before your drop, make it 0 again, go to just after 9 seconds before the end, and make it just the same keyframe by pressing that one, then go to the end and drag it to negative 48 again. So you have that kind of fade in. Now we're gonna make a fade, just a normal fade with the black solid. So we're gonna create a new solid and call it a fade. Press T to get the opacity. Click on a stopwatch to get a keyframe. Go to 2 seconds. Make it 0 so it's all visible. Go just behind. Well, just do the same keyframes as these. And click here to get the same keyframe. And make it 100 again so it's dark. Okay, now we're gonna do a kind of background shake. So we're gonna make a new adjustment layer. Oh, call it, we give it the name shake, and we search for shake. It's also a Yeah, I got it for free, but I think you have to pay for it. But it's a plugin, you can find it on YouTube or wherever you want to search for it. Yeah, not responding, I don't know why, but it's okay. Okay, the shake is working finally. Now, these are the shake settings. So, what you're gonna do is you're gonna change the frequency to 1, the Z dice to 0.97, check motion blur, go to X shake, make it 45, go to Y shake, make it 25, and you have a pretty nice background shake. I'm gonna save it, so if it's gonna crash again, I won't lose it. Okay. Now we're gonna make a new adjustment layer again. Now we're gonna sync. I'm just called sync. Now you get transform. That's a standard effect with After Effects, so don't worry about that. I'm gonna drag up my layer, keyframe the scale, go one further and make it like 175. That's for all our beats. So we also have one here and one here. One here. So these are our C for these things. So now we're gonna find the normal beats. Here's one. And here, and we're gonna end it with 100. So now I'm gonna make full pre-render. Okay, so that's our beat. So now we're gonna make the frame rate like 15. So now we're gonna drag it up like here so we don't have to pre-render it all the time. But now we're gonna search for the I normally say the melody. I don't know what other people call it, but yeah. So 100, one further, and that's 145. There's also one. There's one. Okay, now we'll go over here. There's one. Probably not good. Nope. It's in the middle. So yeah, this is something you should take some time for it because you want to have it perfect. So it looks the best, in my opinion. Yeah. So this is our. Yeah, that's a sync. Now we're gonna watch it in fast. Looks pretty good. We're gonna add some shake to it. And let's say we wanna have 5. And make it 0 over here. And make it 2. Check motion blur. Make the Z diced 0.98. Make this 80. Make this 1.2. make this 41.05 and make this 11. I don't know. Just some random shake settings. I'm pasting these by pressing K, so you go to the next keyframe. And if it will look good, it's all nice. Okay, let's make that wooden 5. Okay, let's see. Maybe some more tilt shake, so we make this 9. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I like this. Okay, now we're gonna add Twitch. It's also a plugin you need to get. I use it a lot because I like it. Okay. Make this 0, keyframe it, next frame. Let's say 25 and this about 300. I don't know. Enable slide and light. Go to operation controls, open slide and make the RGB split 15. Now, by pressing U on the layer, it will only show the keyframes that are active. Okay, we only gonna get shake on the drops, like the beat. That's all, I guess, right? Yeah, that's all. Let's make a pre-render. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I like it. Okay. We're gonna add some glow to it. Just as glow from Sapphire. Make it 0.6, and we also only gonna do it on the drops. So just keep on the same path as the Twitch. So we're gonna click U on it. As you can see, here ends the Twitch, so here ends the glow. We're gonna do that with all. Here ends it. Let's take a look. Yeah, it looks good in my opinion. Okay, now I'm gonna add some optic composition. And we're going to the drop. Select reverse lens, this sort. And 75 is okay. Now we're just gonna do it in the path of the sink. Okay, that's done. Let's take a look. Yeah, that looks really good in my opinion. I really like that. Okay, now we're gonna add for the drop, I guess, a turbulence displace. Then we go to here, 175, 1.1, This is 50. Keyframe, keyframe, keyframe. Then we go one back by pressing J. Then we make this 0. And now we go to like around here. Make this 0, 275. And we're gonna get this to minus 20. Okay, let's take a look. I don't think it looks too bad, so yeah, let's see. Yeah, that's pretty sweet. I think we can size this up to 130. I think that looks much better. So, okay, let's see. Yeah, that's way better. Okay, now I think we also can get one here. And we're gonna make it 110 over here. And 150. One back, 0. And so we're gonna make it negative 100. Now we go over here. Gonna make this 300. 0. 0. Now we're gonna pre-render it. Okay, the render is almost done. And we're gonna take a look how it looks with the second turbulence displays. Not bad, not bad. Okay. I'm also gonna add a shockwave at the start. So here's the shockwave I'm gonna use. And I'm gonna drag it under the camera and make the blending mode add. And I'm also gonna make it 3D. Press P for the position. Make it all 0. Now we're gonna drag it to the drop. As you guys can see, it's red, so we need to fix that. Color balance, HLS, and we're gonna make it blue. Oh, that's a good blue. Okay, the render is done. Let's see. Okay, that looks pretty good. Yeah, I'm happy with it. Maybe we can do something on the side, but I don't know what. I think we can keep it easy, simple. So, now we're gonna make the background. We're gonna get a good spot so we can see it. I think this is a perfect spot. Okay. Now we're gonna click on the... Yeah, we're gonna make a new solid. And we call it BG for background. We drag it above this sun and under the shockwave. Now we're gonna copy it by Ctrl C and Ctrl V. And now we're gonna... Oh shit. That was my mouse. I guess? Or is it my voice? No, it's my mouse. It's okay. So now we're gonna rename it to smoke. Now you need to have the plugin Trapcode form. So okay, if you have the plugin Trapcode form, you go to this person twist, type in 2020, then you go to particle, make the particle type to cloudlet, the opacity to 1 and the size to 222. Now you can see it's like insanely white, so we're gonna make this 25 and it still looks insanely white. That sucks. Okay, we're gonna make it 175. That's okay. Now we're gonna go to blue and make this 15. to give the little blue tone. Yeah, like that. Now we're gonna make particles. So we're gonna make a new solid particles. And then we're gonna go particular. Oh, yeah, here, particular. We have to drag the layer a little bit to the left, so it's, I don't know, it's some weird as plugin. By the way, we're gonna scale this up a little. Okay, we're gonna make the particles per second 30. Make the emitter type bucks. Then you go over here to emitter size and make it all 5000. Then you go to particle, make the particles per second 20 and 2. Then you go particle feather, make it 100. The size, make it 20 or even bigger, 30. Make the opacity 50 and the random also 50. Get a nice color. Make the size random 50 as well. Opacity, we can turn it down to 30. Yeah, that's good. Okay, and then you go to aux system. No, wrong one, physics. Then make it negative, let's say 50. Then it goes downwards, I guess. Oh shit, let's turn off. Yeah, it goes downwards. Okay, that's great. Then you go to air and make this to make it 100. So it will look like it's kind of snowing or something. And maybe we can also add to go to rendering, motion blur, and make it on, so maybe it will look better. Yeah, that looks good in my opinion. Let's turn up the opacity to 50 again. So that's our background. Now we're gonna make the CC. So we go over here and get a new adjustment layer, call it CC, get the effect or plugin Magic Bullet Looks. Probably will crash because, yeah, why not? Then you make it full just only for the CC, and then you click on edit and it will load. So I will see you when it's done loading. Okay, now it's done loading, we see this screen. Yeah, well, if you have like enough, you can go over there. But we're gonna make our own. So first you're gonna grab a contrast and make it 0.05, and as you guys can see, it's a little darker now. Then you guys grab a pop and make it the size 75 and the pop itself 69, and gives it a little shadow. Okay, now we're gonna grab a colorista three-way, or I don't know how to pronounce that. Jeez, that's a hard word. Okay, you're gonna give it the color of your text and make a bit of a little bit, and now as you can see, it's a little bit more blue. So now we go to matte and we're gonna get a normal diffusion, make it a little smaller and give the little blue tone and make the glow 30. Yeah, Now we're gonna get a light flex, make it blue, make it negative 4.7, I guess. Yeah, no, 5.7. Yeah, that's good. Now we get a cool fog, and I'm gonna turn down the size to 20, and I'm gonna get this to negative 0.5, negative 0.05, and make the grade 3. Oh no, let's do 1. Yeah. Now we get another diffusion. We make that 200, 1, 10, 30. No, no. Meant to be 60. 60. And give it a little blue tone. And it edits a little bit. Oh, nope. Now you can add this. It makes it like darker or brighter. So let's do it negative 1. Okay, then we're gonna add a star filter. Make the terresult 0, the boost minus 4, and the size 2. And it's another little glowy thing. So now we go to lens. And we're gonna get an Amoric flare, get a terresult to 0, make the size about 20, the boost negative 4, and make it blue. Okay, now we're gonna get a chromatic thing, make it 1, 1, negative 1. So you see those edges, and you can do like 0.5, 0.5, negative 0.5, so it's less. Now we're gonna add an edge softness. I'll make it like that. Quality 10, blur size 1. Then we go into camera and get a 3-strip process, make it negative 3. And we're gonna get a LUT, and if you don't have that, yeah, just don't. Make it cool. Like that. Maybe we will delete that later, I don't know. Now we go to post, get a bleach, and make it 75, or let's do 60. Yeah, make this 0.5. Then we're gonna get a grash and make it a little bit blue, not too much. Now we're gonna get a US saturation, make the saturation 90, and we can get some curves, but I usually don't do that. Normally I add like a contrast or something and make it, yeah, like that. I'm not too happy about it, so I'm gonna, oh shit, I forgot the vignette. Make it like a little bigger. Now it looks a little better, but I'm not happy with that one. So I'm gonna delete that, and instead of that I'm gonna get a neck bleach and turn this up to 69 and get a color reversal and make this 25. Now we're going back to the unit saturation. We can make this 100 or under 20. Yeah, that looks good. So yeah, that's all I use. Maybe an exposure or something. Yeah. Okay. Let's do this. So, you don't see the smoke very well. So I'm gonna boost this up to 30. Yeah, that's way too much. So, I don't like to see it really good, but yeah, I don't want it to be finished. So, let it load, and I hope this is, yeah, this is way better. So, actually, we've done everything you guys need to know, but I'm gonna turn that off, off again, turn this C off. I'm gonna add some R's and B. So I'm gonna make a new adjustment layer, call it R as in B, and we're gonna do like 1, 1, 1, and then 60. So if we turn on our sync, maybe it will look good, maybe it won't. So we will see. Okay, this is the result with R's and B. It looks okay. So for our last step of the whole intro, we're gonna add black bars. So we're gonna make a new adjustment layer. I call it MT because the effect we're gonna use is called motion tail. I'm gonna make it 80. And that's for our drop. So now we go 5 back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm gonna make it 30. And here we're gonna make it 80 again. So this is actually all you need to know to make a pretty good, normal, decent, I don't know how to call it, intro. So yeah. Okay guys, thanks for watching. I will add the final result at the end of this video, so leave later.